everyone, welcome back to my channel. Recently, I decided to make a bold purchase and buy some designer bowling shoes. Of course, by designer bowling shoes, I mean the white Ace embroidered Gucci sneaker. Very cute shoe. My issue is, I kind of messed them up because I was trying to do something nice for someone and it just ended horribly wrong for me. Now, of course, the long version of that story is I made a basket for this lady and I wanted to deliver it to her house without her finding out it was me, so I tried to run in her driveway and, long story short, I wiped out and, you know, did a number on my knees and my ankles and consequently got blood on my sneakers and kind of scuffed them up a little. Which is really, really disappointing because they are new. But today, I'm going to show you how I'm going to clean them and get them back to looking like they were just bought, because they were. When I say I wiped out, I'm not joking. Oh. See, this is what happens when you try and be nice, which means I'm gonna be an asshole from now on. Of course I'm joking, I'm not gonna be an asshole now. To continue being the nice person I am, I'm still probably going to deliver more baskets because with all of the negativity going around, I want to spread a little bit of positivity. So I want to start off by taking laces out. They did come with an extra pair of laces, so I'm not completely worried if I don't get the blood out. But obviously, I'm still going to try my best to get it out. Because knowing me, I'm probably going to wipe out again. I'm going to have to do this again. Maybe like a lot of times. Sorry, I'm really aggressive with taking the laces out. I think it's part of me because I'm mad that this even happened. A little embarrassed. Like, what if she saw me out of her window just falling? It's a bad situation. Okay, so I'm gonna put these in a bowl of soapy water and just let them soak. Now, while the laces are soaking, I don't want these to lose their shape while I'm cleaning them, so I don't really have anything else to stuff in them other than these stuffed animals. So I'm just gonna shove their faces in there. Get in there. And in you go. Beautiful. Professional. Next up, I'm going to, so Lysol wipes. I read about people using them on their shoes. I don't think that's a very good idea on the leather, but I'm going to use it on this area right here and the bottom, just because it's kind of gross and stuff there. And then on the rest of it, I'm going to use this, these cleansing spa water wipes. I usually use it to take my makeup off. It's very mild, so I think it should be okay on the actual shoe. And just to the rim. The problem with using Lysol wipes on leather is that it makes it all brittle. And, like, dries out the fabric. Now I'm just going to lightly wipe around the actual shoe. You want to be really careful with this area right here because if you get stuff in it, it's really hard to get out. Now that I'm done wiping them with the disinfectant wipe, I'm going to go over it with a shaky little toothbrush and some toothpaste. not too much toothpaste because I don't want to overdo it. That's probably good. Okay, I'm just going to brush in circular motions. And now that it smells all toothpaste-y, I'm going to take a damp cloth and just kind of wipe off the rest. Next up, I'm going to use this deep cleaner for sneakers and sandals from Browns. And I just basically push it down onto the thing, and then it releases the cleanser or whatever. It's fast drying, so. This is good for all kinds of leather shoes. Almost done. I'm going to finish off these shoes with the Michael Kor's rain and stain repellent. So you just kind of spray them but from this distance. If it comes up. Now that stuff is really refusing to come out of the bottle, so I just put a little bit on this tissue, and I'm going to do it like that. Now the shoes look so much whiter and cleaner. I'm really, really happy with how they turned out. I have to leave the repellent spray on for 24 hours, which is okay because I still have to work out the stains in the shoelaces. I think these shoelaces are sufficiently soapy and they're looking pretty white to me, so I'm just gonna rinse them off in a warm bowl of water. Now I just have to wait for the laces to dry so I can lace up my shoes and call it a success. So now that the laces are all dry, I'm gonna go straight into lacing the shoe. You're gonna wanna start by going into the bottom left hole, and then you're going to actually go straight across through this hole on the tongue. And you're gonna diagonally go up through the hole on the top right. Now from there on, it's pretty easy. Just go over to the hole that's right across from the bottom left one, and then under diagonally up like that, and again go over and then diagonally under. Over, under, over, For this part, you want to go through the hole in the tongue again. Yeah, like after about 4 lines. And then just do it how you normally do it. Go under diagonally. Then you go over again. Under. Over. And under. That. Just lace them up. And there you have it. They're all clean, whiter than when I bought them. Yes. Here's the finishing product. So you can see, they're much whiter than they even were to begin. Very clean, and the laces don't have blood stains in them anymore, which is excellent. Now, I hope this video was helpful for you if you're also living with some dirty designer sneakers that you want to take care of and lace up. I'm really happy with how these turned out. This is actually my first time cleaning these sneakers, so I was kind of going in blind. But I'm really happy with it. They look clean. They don't look like they actually were ever even worn yet. So I think I did a good job. Anyways, if there's anything you'd like to see from me in particular, just feel free and comment below. Other than that, take care and I'll see you again soon. Bye bye.